Hello friends, I am Siddhi Shamsukha, studying degree plus civil services coaching in Sarat Chandra IAS Academy. Today, I am going to explain you all about the slowdown in Indian economy. Why is it in news? India has seen economic slowdown from past two quarters, that is from 2019, in the sectors of real estate, automobiles, construction sector, and overall consumption demand has been constantly declining. The total GDP growth rate has declined so much that it has reached to up to 4.5% GDP growth rate, which has been the least in the past 6 years. What do you think that are the factors that might affect the economic slowdown? First, let us talk about the cyclical factors. These are the factors which affect for a very short term time. It includes demand and supply mismatch, impacts of demonetization, GST on the unorganized sector, structural reforms. These include lack of land reforms, labor reforms, infrastructure gaps, etc. According to the chief economic advisor of economics in India is Arvind Subramaniam, who has recently told in news that India has been moving from twin balance sheet syndrome to four balance sheet syndrome. Now you might be thinking, what is four balance sheet syndrome? Let me tell you all. First thing is NPAs of bank, that is non-performing assets. On the second place is corporates fear that there is high in increase, means there are high borrowing rates. Third is assets liability mismatch in the non-banking financial corporations. And fourth is a steep decline in the demand of real estates. Other factors might include unemployment, scarcity of capital, underdeveloped infrastructure, corruption, etc. Now friends, do you know that international relations of India with other countries also affect the economy of India? Let us take few examples. On the first, the US-China trade war, which you all must have heard in the recent news. US and China have imposed tariffs on each other, which has led to the global economic slowdown. It has affected drastically on the value of the rupee. Not only on the value of rupee, it has decreased the investments from the foreign countries to India and also affected the exports, which are already at a very dismal growth rate. Second, the Countering America's Adversaries Through Sanctions Act, CATSA, or US Sanction Act, where the US has imposed sanctions on many countries like Russia, Iran, North Korea, etc. But you must be thinking, how will this affect the Indian economy? Now, India is one of the major importers of crude oil from Iran and defense and intelligence from Russia, which will affect the economy of the country. On the third place is revoking of the Generalized System of Preferences, GSP, of the USA, which has taken out India from that category. India has lost a great market in the United States of America. Now, even the slowdown in the Indian economy will also affect the state governments, as most of the revenues come from the central government, like RBI revenues, disinvestment, etc. The compensation of the goods and services tax, GST, is given to the state by the center, which will obviously get affected if there is a slowdown in the Indian economy. So, government has taken some of the major steps to reshape the Indian economy. Some of them are trickle-down economic policies. Now, what does it mean? Trickle-down economic policy refers to decreasing the tax rates of the corporate rich people. Second is recapitalization of the Indian economy. Third, reducing the surcharge on the foreign institutional investments and even the angel tax on the startups and etc. Compensation of GST to the states have been started. Now, what are the solutions for the slowdown in the Indian economy? Let us start. The first one is, government should address the cyclical factors by using counter-cyclical measures. For example, monetary policy transmission, where when the RBI decreases its repo rate, even the banking sector should also decrease the repo rate. But nowadays, the banks are not doing so for their profit purpose. Second is that government should decrease their indirect taxes and even if possible should decrease the GST slab rates. Government should enhance direct benefit transfer to the farmers. Government should also address the problems of the unorganized sector. The Nobel Peace Prize winner of 2019 in economics, Abhijit Banerjee, has told that government should focus on quality of life. So I've told you about the non-banking financial corporations and NPAs, but how can we reshape or revamp it? We should use the 5R policy, starting from the first R, that is recognition of the non-performing assets. Second, resolution of the non-performing assets by using insolvency bankruptcy code and bad banks. What is bad banks? It doesn't mean that the bank is bad. It is that it takes all the NPAs from the other banks and reduces the stress on the banking sector so that they can lend loans at low interest rate. Third R is regulation of non-banking financial corporations. Fourth R is recapitalization of the Indian economy. Fifth R is reforms. For example, the PGNI committee has given bank reforms which needs to be implemented at a serious note. The other solutions include increasing the investments in research and development, increasing the commercial codes, and increasing e-governance, for example, e-biz, etc. In my opinion, the functions like monetary policy, banking, supervision, data collection and dissemination, auditing of financial accounts should be free from government's interest. If at all India follows all these reforms mentioned, the days are not too far when India will reach its dream goal, that is $5 trillion economy by 2025. Thank you.